Alhamdulillahirrahmanirrahim. Salatu wassalam ala syarafil anbiya wal mursalin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Yang berhormat Datuk Halim bin Hussein, State Legislative Assembly Speaker, Muhammad Datuk Haji bin Malik Abdul Kasim, Penang State Executive Council, our distinguished speaker for today, Professor Dr. Tariq Ramadhan, Professor Dr. Ahmad Farouk Musa, members of State Legislative Assembly, heads of department, representative from various government agencies, representative from non-governmental organizations, distinguished guests, members of the media, ladies and gentlemen. On behalf of the state government and Penang Islamic Foundation or Yayasan Islam Negeri Pulau Pinang, allow me to start by wishing everyone a warm welcome to the first Yayasan Islam Pulau Pinang lecture series, A Civil State, Ideas and Challenges, to be delivered by a renowned scholar, Professor Tariq Ramadhan. We are happy to have Professor Tariq Ramadhan today. And of course, I would like to say very thank you for Dr. Ahmad Farouk Musa for bringing Professor Tariq Ramadhan here. Professor Tariq Ramadhan was here yesterday and will be here for another session in Perlis and in Kuala Lumpur. And all these are done by Dr. Ahmad Farouk. Thank you very much, Dr. Ahmad Farouk. Civil state, a term that we have been hearing a lot in recent days. And right after being declared the new president of Egypt, after the Arab Spring, Mohamed Morsi, both that Egypt remains a civil state. And in Syria, the National Council, which gathers many dissent parties from left and right, called for an establishment of a democratic civil state. The concept of civil state, or Ad-Dawah Al-Madiniya in Arabic, spreads like wildfire among the intellectuals and politicians. But what is civil state? What does it mean to us? And the whole world continues to monitor with interest the development in the Middle East, and especially after the Arab Spring. How will the Arab Spring change the political landscape in the Middle East? Will it become the catalyst for the development of a civil state? Or is it too soon to tell? And I will leave this, of course, to Professor Tariq to answer, and I'm sure he will address this very comprehensively in his speech afterwards. And ladies and gentlemen, the development of a civil state does not happen only in Middle East. It is, of course, it is a worldwide phenomenon. Even before what happened in Middle East, people have been talking about it. And in the Malaysian context, the concept of a civil state or negara madani, based on democratic values and the federal constitution, has been a subject of discussion, especially among the politicians and opinion leaders, for quite some time now. And unfortunately, due to the lack of understanding, or maybe also the lack of political will, those championing the Negara Madani is often labeled as secular, practicing religious pluralism, and go against the very teaching of Islam. And we propagate the concept of Negara Madani and Masyarakat Madani because we want to empower the society. We want a civil society who knows their rights and those when to exercise their rights. We want to build a just society, a society that has the courage to uphold justice, a society that is passionate in combating corruption, fighting injustice, rejecting violence, and speaking up against the abuse of power. I say yes, in fact, to Masyarakat Madani, we are returning the power to the people, not only during general election, but throughout their lifespan. And it will definitely help to speed up our objective of achieving true democracy and clean governance. Ladies and gentlemen, although civil state has become a coveted wish for most people, especially after the leaders of the popular